we want to graph the given quadratic function using this online graphing tool. To use this tool, we would have to select the parabola graphing tool here, and then to graph a parabola, we click on the vertex and then one other point on the parabola. But before we do this using this tool, let's work out some things by hand. The first thing we should recognize is that the given quadratic function is in standard form, also called vertex form or graphing form, given by this form here, y equals a times the quantity x minus h squared plus k. If a quadratic function is in this form, then h will be the x coordinate of the vertex, and k will be the y coordinate. So looking at our quadratic function, we should be able to identify the vertex without doing any work. Looking at our quadratic function, notice how we have x minus 2 here, which means the x coordinate will be positive 2. If it was x plus 2, the x coordinate would be negative 2. And because we have a minus 3 here on the end, the y coordinate is negative 3. So that can be a little tricky. Notice how the x coordinate is the opposite sign of what we see. Again, if it's minus 2 next to the x coordinate is positive 2. If we had a plus 2 here, the x coordinate would be negative 2. But if we see minus 3 here on the end, this will be the sign of the y coordinate of the vertex. A minus 3 here means the y coordinate is negative 3. If it was plus 3, the y coordinate would be positive 3. One more thing to notice here is that since the value of a here is negative 3, the parabola will open down. So if a is less than 0 or negative, the parabola opens down, meaning it will look something like this. Now we need one other point to make an accurate graph of the parabola. Many times it's convenient to find the y-intercept as another point on the parabola, but it's only helpful if that point is on this coordinate plane. So let's just say, for example, we did try to find the y-intercept. The y-intercept occurs when the x-coordinate is equal to 0. So let's substitute 0 for x and see what we get for y. F of 0 would be negative 3 times 0 minus 2 squared, or negative 2 squared minus 3. Well, this would be negative 3, negative 2 squared is 4, so negative 3 times 4 minus 3, that's negative 12 minus 3, or negative 15. So while this is a point on the parabola, notice the point 0, negative 15 would be off the provided coordinate plane. So a helpful hint to find a second point on the parabola would be to always select an x-coordinate that's close to the x-coordinate of the vertex. So notice here, the x-coordinate of the vertex is positive 2. So selecting an x-value of positive 1 or positive 3 would more than likely give us a point on the provided coordinate plane. So let's find a point when the x-coordinate is positive 1. So now we'll find f of 1, which would be negative 3 times the quantity 1 minus 2, that'd be negative 1, squared minus 3. Well, negative 1 squared is positive 1, so negative 3 times positive 1 minus 3 would be negative 6. Notice how this point would be on the coordinate plane. So now to graph the parabola, we will use the vertex, and we'll use this point here as our second point. Let's first graph it by hand, and then we'll go back to the graphing tool. So the vertex has coordinates 2, negative 3, which is here. We know the parabola opens down, and notice how the second point would be 1, negative 6, which is here. But remember, the axis of symmetry also passes through the vertex, which would be this vertical line here. And because this point here is 1 unit to the left of the axis of symmetry, there must be another point 1 unit to the right of the axis of symmetry, or this point here. So the graph of the parabola would look something like this. Now let's go ahead and graph this using our online graphing tool. First step, select the parabola graphing tool here. Next step, click on the vertex, which is 2, negative 3 here. Next step, click on our second point, which has coordinates 1, negative 6, which is here. And let's go ahead and check it. Notice how our score is 1 out of 1, which means we did graph this correctly. I hope you found this helpful.